Vaccines could be the next big thing in the fight against cancer. Currently, the vaccines come in two different types, a preventative such as the HPV shot, which helps prevent cervical cancer, or the hepatitis B vaccine, which helps prevent liver cancer. These vaccines have proven to be quite successful, but there's another area of study that's in its infant stage, therapeutic vaccines or treatment vaccines. These vaccines, often given by injection or IV, stimulate the immune system to attack cancer cells.
It's like putting a red flag on the cancer cell and saying, you know, I'm a cancer cell, immune system, you should recognize me and you should kill me.
Many are in the clinical testing phase, so they're not easily available to the general public, but they are used with patients already battling cancer. In lung cancer, for example, about 20% of patients respond well to the vaccine, says Dr. Chris Page. The immune system is able to recognize which cells are cancerous and attack them.
But in there would be a variety.
This is a big breakthrough, but the overarching question that researchers around the world are now trying to understand is why it works for some patients.
So we still don't know the answer to questions like those, and that's going to be one of the most important areas of research going forward.
Understanding the why could lead to future vaccines that don't allow for cancer cells to grow in the first place. But when it comes to manipulating the immune system to be able to do such a thing, experts say it is quite challenging. A functioning immune system is supposed to attack foreign and dangerous substances, but it should also be able to recognize which cells are healthy and leave those alone.
Those that are trying to do experiments to understand how to boost the immune system always have to walk a very fine line between enhancing that aspect of the immune system that you'd like to enhance, the anti-cancer part, with that part that you don't want to change, which is the ability to leave normal tissues alone and avoid autoimmunity.
Dr. Page says, although it's still in the early days, he recommends that patients ask their healthcare providers if a cancer vaccine would be right for them. Depending on the type of cancer, a vaccine could be used in conjunction with more traditional treatment, such as chemotherapy and radiation. For more on the story, visit globalnews.ca.